Hi, welcome to week 4 of the course on OERs. In this week, we will be looking at how to access, reuse, revise and remix OERs. Just to revise, what are the four principles of open educational resources? We have four R's, which are commonly called the four freedoms. The four freedoms are: resources can be accessed for free and used, that is reuse. Resources can be revised, adapted and to be made more relevant, that is revise. You can combine different kinds of materials, different kinds of resources to make a new resource, and that is called remix. And a resource that has been so modified, either revised or remixed, can be redistributed. That is, you can share the revised and remixed resource with others. To allow for these four freedoms, the OER or the resource must be shared under a Creative Commons license, which allows these four freedoms. In week 2, we have already discussed and learned what are the various forms of Creative Commons license that can be adopted for the OER that you create. Just before we get into how to reuse and revise and remix OERs, I just want to take a minute to briefly talk about the different kinds of OERs that we may be encountering. There are OERs that are already shared and they are already free, and then they are already created academic content. For instance, the Khan Academy video or Test Africa materials. These are resources that you can access, download, possibly dub or show it in your classroom or have a discussion around, etc. There are the other kinds of OERs which are free course materials and courses. For instance, a course like the current one that we are going through is also an open educational resource. And there is another kind of OER which is a creation which is completely collaborative in nature, like the Wikipedia. And the NROER is a similar collaborative platform that is being envisaged, and the Karnataka Open Educational Resources is a collaborative resource creation portal of Karnataka government teachers. So there are different kinds of OERs, and what is important is to remember that these are dynamic, these are not static point in time resources, and they are continuously updated. What distinguishes the academic content that is created by a few and shared, like a course or a university course, from Wikipedia is that the second one, that is a Wikipedia kind of OER, actually involves the creative efforts of many people. It's collaborative, there are multiple perspectives involved, and it's what is commonly called as a crowdsourced model of resource creation. You were made familiar with an exercise, slightly similar exercise in week 2, when you actually accessed multiple pages and wrote on a course wiki page. Wikipedia materials work somewhat in similar ways. And the Karnataka Open Educational Resources is also an example of how teachers come together to create resources. Now we will look at now that we have looked at the kinds of OERs and what are the characteristics, we will look at what are these four freedoms that we are talking about. What are these various ways in which we can work with OERs? The reuse is something that we are very familiar with. You access a link, you access a document, you access a video, you access an image, you can download it, you can use it, you can share it, you can mail it, and you can discuss it. These are different ways of reuse, all of which we are familiar with. In the first few weeks of the course, you've already been exposed to that. Now, when you reuse a resource, for instance, you can either use it as it is or you can revise it. So that brings us to the next freedom associated with OERs, which is that of revising. Now, you can revise it by an addition, by correction of an errata, or by translation, or by adding material. Any of these methods of working with the OERs do constitute a revision. For example, now I'm going to show you a file that has been shared by a mathematics teacher. It has been created in an application called GeoGebra. You can see here that the teacher has actually created some kind of an input box, kind of spreadsheet for actually talking about cardinal numbers of sets. Now this has been shared in the subject teacher forum of Karnataka, And another teacher, she's actually taken that same file and actually edited it, and she has taken his permission and she has actually edited that file and added Urdu to it. This is an example of remix. You can see the email exchange between the two teachers. Dear teachers, I made an edit on this file of Taranath sir and I got his permission. And having taken his permission, she's actually gone ahead and edited this. This is an example of how resources are created with the express purpose of allowing other people to share, other people to modify, and people do use that opportunity to access it, modify it, revise it as per their requirements. Now, when you are revising, it is not necessary that the resource should be kept in the same format and the same type that it was originally created in. It is also possible to remix or bring together multiple resources to create a new resource. For instance, I'm going to take you to a page on Karnataka Open Educational Resources. Let's say this is a topic on light, for instance. And here you will find that it is actually a wiki page, but that wiki page has embedded in it a mind map, which is a form of concept mapping application. Some of these tools have already been introduced to in week 3 under the FOS tool section for OER creation. So this resource page actually embeds a mind map, embeds an image, which is actually a graphic image of a mind map that has been created. It embeds videos, and it embeds even screenshots of videos, basically images. And you can actually write text around it. You can actually use a resource. You can add to a resource. A video is not just a video, but a video associated with a discussion becomes a valuable lesson resource. And for instance, you can actually see here that a video has been used. Different text materials have been used. Here there is a simulation, a FET simulation that has been embedded, and a lesson has been created around it. So there are multiple ways in which you can revise resources. And this form of revision is what we call remix, where we have brought together different forms of resources. So it's no longer limited to only text or only video or only audio, but bringing together all formats of resources to create materials. So this is another, this is a form of remixing of resources. And a resource that is so created can be redistributed again as an open educational resources. The resource that has therefore been made in this particular way has again been shared on COIR under Creative Commons license. So this becomes a resource that people can use for further sharing as they go ahead in their work. For the course for this week, we have two activities that you will have to do to practice the principles of revising and remixing. So first we will take a look at an activity for remixing. You can take two topics from the Wikipedia which are connected and which are of interest to you based on your subject area. Try to create a third article by taking parts from each article. Translate this if you can, and add references to other multimedia content that can be used for a discussion on the same topic. Share this article in the discussion forum and given below the activity for remixing resources. A second activity for you to do would be to actually revise another article, any article from a Wikipedia page that is of relevance and interest to you. Revise the article in your computer using a text editor, preferably use track changes or record changes, and type in a different language if you can, and share the revised article in the discussion forum. These would give you some kind of an introduction to what are the principles that go into revising or remixing a resource, and you can also reflect on what are the learning possibilities such adaptation allows when you're actually working with OERs, and how does it contrast with resources that are made at a point in time and shared with teachers and students. That is it from the introductory point of view. Hope you enjoy playing with resources, and we can discuss more on what are the learning possibilities that these adaptations give when we are actually discussing on this week. This week we'll also have a quiz that you will have to take, which actually sums up the experience of going through open educational resources and what are the possibilities that it provides for teaching learning and for self-learning. And that quiz will be shared and made available shortly. Thanks, and hope you enjoy this week.